Welcome to this fourth program on making play material for children. In the preceding three programs, we saw how to make puppets and masks using low-cost material. Let us see where Mr. Satyanarayana leads our imagination this time. But before that, I would like to share an experience with you. One day, I made a list of things that were not being used in my house and which I had decided to throw away. My list included items like old tin containers, discarded plastic bottles, caps of these used bottles, beads from broken necklaces, the covers of old notebooks, empty shoe boxes, old torn handkerchiefs, the broken frame of my brother's spectacles, a part of an old sari, leftover pieces of cloth after sewing, empty match boxes, old unusable pens, leftover wool, wires and ropes, and old thread reels. As I was making the list, ideas regarding how I could use these things for making play materials occurred to me. Upon some thinking, I found that I could make at least 10 different kinds of play material from them. For example, the empty thread reel could be used as a long nose of a puppet or the trunk of an elephant. By making holes in the bottle caps and stringing them in a wire, I could make a musical instrument. What else do you think you can make with these things? And why just these? There must be other similar things at your house which you do not use and which you would have thrown in any case. List them out and collect them, and you will find that ideas regarding how they can be used for making toys begin to strike you. Why not give it a try? So let us see what Mr. Satyanarayana has to show us today. He is going to show us how to make toys from paper mache. For this, you need three things: some old newspapers, multani mitti or khadiya mitti, and a granular edible gum called dhabde ka gund, which you can find at any general merchant's shop. Add to these ingredients some imagination, stir them well, and behold, you have the most attractive toys ready.
The first step in making toys from paper mache is to tear old paper into small pieces. The smaller the pieces, the better would be the end product. You can involve children in tearing this paper. They will enjoy it, and it is good for improving their eye and hand coordination. Then soak these paper pieces in water for a period of 3 days. At the end of the period, take out the pieces and grind them using a stone. Grind them very fine till they become like this. Now mix it with khadiya mitti or multani mitti, which should have been ground separately. The ratio between ground paper and khadiya or multani mitti is important. If you want the toys to be light, then take more of ground paper and less of the mitti. If you want them to be heavy, then take more mitti as compared to ground paper. However, it is best to take ground paper and mitti in equal amounts. Here, we are taking equal amounts of both. First, grind the mitti separately before mixing it with ground paper. This will make it easier to mix the two together. Now, add edible granular gum or dhabde ka gund, as it is known in Hindi, to this mixture. If the mixture of ground paper and khadiya mitti weighs 1 kg, then mix 100 grams of dhabde ka gund. Now add a little water at a time to this mixture and make a smooth paste. It will become like this. An important point to remember is that toys made from paper mache must not be dried in the sun, or else they will crack. Dry them in the shade. The smoother and softer the paste and the more homogeneous it is, the better will be the toys. Add water as needed. As you knead it, it will become like this. The basic form for making man or animal is the same. These are the arms. And these, the legs. This is the basic form. As we attach the head, it becomes a human figure. Use a stick to join the head and the body, or else the head will fall off. This very basic form can be converted into an animal form if you turn the upper limbs downwards and give a slight shape to the face. You can also attach a tail. Watch carefully to see how this is done. You can now make the eyes and nose. Paper mache has one advantage over potter's clay. Once the toys have been made by potter's clay, you cannot make any additions after they have dried. However, this can be done by toys made from paper mache. To do so, just wet the area where you want to add the next part. Thus, if a child has left a model incomplete, he can come back to it later and finish it. Children enjoy this activity of giving shape and form to their ideas. Use a short, thin stick to smoothen uneven surfaces. You can make beads by piercing a ball of clay with the help of medium-sized stick. This bead can be removed from the stick once it dries. Color these beads to make them attractive for children. To make them last longer, you can also varnish them. These can be threaded together to make a necklace while doing drama. Such beads can be used for teaching concepts to children.
बाद में इसको रंग कर लीजिए और आपको और ही पक्का करना है तो रंग करने के बाद इस पे आप वार्निश कर दीजिए तो देखने बिल्कुल ही पक्का लगेगा तरह से। तो आप इसके और भी इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं डॉल में बनाने के लिए या आप वैसे खुद भी पहनने के लिए कभी नाटक वगैरह करना हो तो इसका भी इस्तेमाल हो सकता है। सबके सब बाहर निकल जाता है और सबसे बड़ी बात है इसमें बच्चों को सब कुछ करने से
The important point is to involve the children at each stage of preparing paper mache. Ask them to tear the paper and to grind it. You can break these toys and reuse paper mache. These are some of the toys made by the children. This is a face. This a snake. Giraffe. Elephant, and this is a doll. Allow children to give any shape they want to their imagination. Appreciate what they have made. Important point is that they are trying to imagine and create. How good is their product in our terms is not important at all.
You saw that there are 5 stages in making paper mache. Let us recall them. Tear the paper into small pieces and soak it in water for 3 days. Take the paper pieces out of water after 3 days and grind them using a stone. Grind the multani mitti or khadiya mitti as well. Now mix the ground paper and the mitti together and add some dhabde ka gond or the granular edible gum. Then use water to prepare soft clay and give it any shape you desire. You saw that paper mache is used just as plasticine or potter's clay. However, it has advantages over both. Firstly, it is low cost compared to plasticine. Secondly, children can not only make toys with paper mache, they can also participate in the process of making lugdi or clay. You may have seen some educators use flashcards while narrating stories. These are an effective accompaniment to your narration. The principle involved in making them is as follows. First, identify the main events of your story. Then, depict each of these events on a cardboard or a paper as has been done here. These cards have been made by the workers of a voluntary organization called the Mobile Creche. Through these cards, they have depicted the story of Choo Choo. In the first flashcard, one can see Choo Choo and his mother probably talking to each other. In the second flashcard, one can see Choo Choo eating some peas. The third flashcard shows Choo Choo and his mother talking to a parrot. Here, Here, in the fourth flashcard, they are seen talking to a pigeon. And in the fifth flashcard, they are talking to a crane. Behind each of these flashcards, write down the narration related to that particular event as has been done here. So that in case you forget the narration, you can look it up from behind. To make the flashcards last longer, the workers have put cloth on all the four sides so that it does not tear. Let us now see what story the educators narrated using these flashcards.
Chuchu jo hai bahut ro raha tha. Usne Chuchu se kaha ki Chuchu beta kya hua? To Chuchu ne apni maa murgi ko sari baat batayi. Theek hai? Sari baat batayi. Usne kaha mere gale mein मटर का दाना फंसा है. क्या फंसा है? ये है मटर का दाना. ठीक है. मुर्गी जो है किसके पास गई? तोते के पास गई. अपने दोस्त तोते के पास गई और उसने कहा कि तोते भाई चूचू के गले में मटर का दाना फंस गया है, तुम उसको निकाल दो. तो तोते ने कहा, क्या कहा तोते ने? मेरी चोंच टेढ़ी है और मोटी है, उसके गले में नहीं आएगी. ठीक है. उसने कहा तोते ने, तुम कबूतर के पास जाओ. किसके पास जाओ? कबूतर के पास जाओ. मुर्गी जो है किसके पास पहुंची?
कबूतर के पास.
ये कौन है?
कबूतर.
मुर्गी ने कहा, कबूतर भाई चूचू के गले में मटर का दाना फंस गया है. तो कबूतर ने क्या कहा? मेरी चोंच छोटी है, चूचू के गले में नहीं घुस पाएगी. मेरी चोंच छोटी है, तुम जो है सारस के पास जाओ. के पास जाओ?
सारस के पास.
फिर मुर्गी जो है जल्दी 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 सारस के पास पहुंची. किसके पास पहुंची?
सारस
के पास. और उसने सारस से कहा, मुर्गी ने, कि आपकी चोंच लंबी है और पतली है, चूचू के गले में मटर का दाना फंसा है, उसे निकाल दो. सारस ने अपनी चोंच चूचू की चोंच में डाली और मटर का दाना निकाल दिया.
एजुकेटर्स ऑफ द जामिया नर्सरी सिचुएटेड इन द जामिया मिलिया इस्लामिया यूनिवर्सिटी हैव मेड सम एक्सीलेंट पपेट्स. वन ऑफ द एजुकेटर्स फ्रॉम दिस सेंटर विल एक्सप्लेन टू अस हाउ टू मेक सम ऑफ देम.
This is a snake. It has been made by stuffing an old red towel. We have used old socks to make the face. The socks and towels have been attached here.
Attached कर दिया. यहाँ पे इसको सी दिया. और इस मोजे की एड़ी और
By inserting one's hand into the socks, one can move the mouth. Thermocol has been used for the teeth and eyes.
और आंखें भी जरा नुमाया करने के लिए इसकी जरा उभरी भी अलग से टांग दी है. ये इस तरह इसका मुंह और इसको मूवमेंट.
Besides the movement of the mouth, the entire snake can be moved with the help of these two sticks attached to its body. जो two people are needed to move the snake. It will be difficult for one person to do that.
दो लोग आसानी से चला सकते हैं, एक के लिए जरा मुश्किल होगा. तो हर पपेट को अलग अलग कोई कैरेक्टर.
As you can see, every puppet has been given a specific shape and expression, which enhances its peculiar characteristics.
शक्ल दी है उसको नुमाया करने के लिए उसको, इसलिए ये ऐसे चलाने के लिए इसका आसानी से.
This is another puppet made by using two sticks, one very short and another a little longer. The short stick has been fitted into the face and a nail has been inserted in the short stick and another into the longer one. The two sticks have then been joined together using a spring. Had just a single stick been used, then this variety of movement would not have been possible. The face of the puppet has been made using a ball. The ball has been covered with a cloth and the features have then been embroidered. The movement in this puppet is based on a different principle. This is a joker. Its neck can be made short or long. Its head moves up and down. It turns left, right, forward and backward in any direction that you want. This has been made using a metal pipe, the type that can be found at the top of a common broom. The body of the puppet has been made by stuffing cotton and old rags. It has been attached to this area, here. A stick has been inserted through there, and on the top of the stick, a ball has been attached to make the face. The stick has then been covered with a cloth. The metal pipe has been sewed on to the body with a thread. This leaves the stick free to move through the broom and through the body. Insert one hand through the dress and move it as you like. This is a horse. To make this, we first cut out the shape of the horse's face and then we stuffed it with cotton. The horse's face has been attached to the stick here and a dress has been made for it. To produce the typical sound of a horse drawing a wagon, bells have been tied to the rope. This rope has been fitted to the horse to give the effect of pulling at its reins. As you pull this rope and move the horse up and down, the bells jingle.
In the four parts of this program, you have seen how to make toys using low-cost material. However, these are not the only type of play materials that can be made. In our other programs, you shall come across many more ideas regarding making toys for children. Our various vlogs also contain many such examples. At this point, we have a suggestion which can be carried out if you cooperate. If each one of you writes to us the method of making a play material, then the information sent by each one of you can be compiled and printed in the form of a booklet, which will be then available to all of you. If along with writing the method of making the toy, you also make illustrations regarding each step, then it shall become easier to understand. Please send us this information at the following address: Dr. Prabha Chawla, Professor, Women's Education, Block No. 2, Indira Gandhi National Open University, Maidangadi, New Delhi, 110068. We will be waiting for your letters. In the meantime, we hope you have a memorable time making these toys for children.